welcome to the UniLab. Today we're talking all about bridges. How do bridges hold all those people, cars, and buses above ground? And how does it hold itself up when it's so heavy? Let's find out. But first, click the red button to become a UniLander. Let's go. More than 500,000 bridges throughout the U.S. that people rely on to cross over streams, valleys, and even oceans. But did you know since ancient times, engineers have designed three major types of bridges to withstand the force of nature and pull of gravity? Pretty cool, huh? Nowadays, there are four main types of bridges. Beam bridges, made of horizontal beams, supported by piers at each end. Truss bridges, made from a combination of triangles made of steel. Arch bridges that are made up of arches supporting the bridge that are naturally strong due to its shape. And finally, suspension bridges that are long bridges, such as the Golden Gate Bridge, that work with a little something called tension. I said suspension bridges work with a little something called tension. Tension means pulling something tight. So suspension bridges are made of decks that are suspended or hung with thick cables that stretch from one side of the bridge to the other. The cables are supported by huge towers and anchored down or held down tightly on both ends. Suspension bridges are so strong because the weight is spread out through all its pieces. So when people, animals, or vehicles are traveling on the bridge, they create tension that pulls on the towers and anchors to keep the bridge upright. So no matter what shape, the bridges are strong because of some smart mathematical design by some clever engineers. We can investigate the engineering behind bridges by making our own simple bridge out of paper. But wait, can you really make a bridge out of paper? Grab your safety goggles and join me in the lab. To create your very own bridge, you will need a sheet of construction paper or printer paper, a stack of construction paper books or something about the same size, 30 or more coins, tape, and a ruler. First, place a few books on one end of the table. Grab your ruler and measure exactly 10 inches from one side to the other. Make sure each stack is equal so our pillars can be perfectly balanced. And remember, don't move the pillars or we might have a disaster. Now put your paper on top of the books. With one edge on each stack. See the paper fall under its own weight? What do you think we need to do to get it to stand up and hold a few coins? I got it! You need to distribute or even out the way if you want it to hold something up. So let's try folding the paper. You see, if you fold the paper, you're strengthening the paper. Let's put two small pieces of tape on each side of the bridge so it doesn't unfold. Now, how do we get these coins on? Ooh, using what we know about suspension bridges, we have to distribute the weight across the bridge to create an anchor. So let's try adding a coin on either side until we fill up the bridge. Ooh, there you go. You've built yourself a very handy and simple bridge deck. We've recreated the job of crafty engineers using just paper, coins, and a little brain power. Try to test out how many coins you can stack. Can you come up with a different bridge design? And don't forget to let me know if your little bridge holds up against the competition. Ha! Get it? Thanks for watching. hit the red button to become a UniLander. And let us know in the comments down below how many coins you managed to fit on your bridge. See you later.